So we solve example 4.2, and example 4.2 is basically saying that find the electric field produced by a uniformly polarized sphere of radius r. We are having a sphere which is having radius r, and there is a uniform polarization P, and we consider this polarization in the z direction. Now the polarization is along the z direction, so we have to calculate that when it is a situation, then do calculate the electric field due to such polarization, what electric field it will produce. So we will proceed toward the solution here. And here it is evident that is we know two things. One is sigma b, which is p dot n, and the other is rho p, the volume bound charge, which is minus divergence of the polarization. Now, when the polarization is uniform, then we have no divergence here. So this thing will come out to be equal to zero. So we have no contribution from the volume bound charge, and only the surface bound charge will contribute. So sigma B will come out to be equal to P times N, and there is angle between the P and N. P is along the Z direction. So we are having the one thing here we will have to see that this is in the z direction. So I have made the arrows not right. So this is in the z direction. So it comes in from here. I will explain this later, but it comes in from here, goes out there, and then when it reaches here, it moves like this. Okay, so here it's in the z direction, so I have this P of cos of theta. Between the P and the N, the angle is theta, so P dot N will come out to be P cos theta. Now for such a geometry, we have already found the potential in example 3.9, and that is that V of r theta due to a dipole, we have found this thing equal to P over 3 epsilon naught in r cos theta for r less than or equal to r, means inside the sphere. And then this is P over 3 epsilon naught, 3 epsilon naught and r cube over r square cos of theta for r greater or equal to r, means outside the sphere we are having the potential equal to this. Now what we are supposed to find, we are supposed to find the electric field in this geometry inside and outside of the sphere. So we will have to find the electric field. We know a relation. The relation between the electric field and potential is electric field is the negative gradient of V. So we are having V here. So for a situation when R is less than R, we have V equal to P and thus equal to R cos theta here. So let me write this thing. If I consider the R cos theta here, then this is theta, so the Z component of this from the spherical polar coordinates, I know that Z is equal to R cos theta. So I can write that V of R in theta as well. So is I'm now writing this thing in terms of Z sub, I will write V of R equals P over 3 epsilon naught. And for R cos theta, let me write Z, and this will be the Z is for R cos theta. Okay, now I will have to take the gradient. So the gradient, I know that gradient is equal to partial over partial x in x plus partial over partial y in y and partial over partial z in z. So here is only z available, so this will give 0, this will give 0, and we will have to apply it on this one. So the E equals minus gradient of V is apply curly by curly z on this, so it will come out to be 1. So we have P over 3 epsilon naught, and minus sign is here, so minus P over 3 epsilon naught, and z partial over partial z of z is 1, so only the z direction here. So here the electric field will come out to be minus R P over 3 epsilon naught P over 3 epsilon naught, and in the minus z direction. So when we apply field here, then the field here will be in the minus z direction. This is the z direction, so for the field it will be inside the sphere. For r less than r, we will have the field direction is like this. If we take the polarization direction in that one, then the field direction will be opposite to that one. We will have to mark it like this. Now when I go to the situation, and the situation is when R is greater or equal to R, means I am outside the sphere, then for outside the sphere I will have to write V of R theta. V of R theta is equal to P over 3 epsilon naught R cube over R squared in cos of theta. Now I can further write this thing in terms of only R like this, that we know that polarization P is the dipole moment over volume. So P, small p, will be equal to capital P multiplied with this, capital P multiplied with volume. So here I'm having capital P, so I write V of R theta is equal to write this P. So for this I write small p over volume. This is volume, this is potential. So we will have to differentiate a bit writing it in capital. And here I will have to p over this, and then 1 over 3 epsilon naught and r cube over r square cos of theta. So this is equal to small p and cos theta I write, while this one is the volume of the sphere, 4 by 3 pi r cube. This is 1 over 3 epsilon naught, and this is r cube over r square. Now I can see here that 3 is gone with 3, r cube is gone here with r cube, and what remains here is v of r theta is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and here is 1 over r square, and p cos theta over r squared. So the I can further write this thing is, to get rid of theta here, I write v of r and 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. What I can write this one, p dot r unit vector over r squared. Now it will be v of r p dot r over r square, and this is the potential of, I know that this potential is basically the potential of a perfect dipole, so it behaves like a perfect dipole outside when I measure its potential. And in the same manner, I can calculate its electric field, and its electric field will be again E equals minus gradient of V. So I have to do this thing because of theta r square. Here I did easily this thing by just converting partial z. For this one I will have to go back again to this one, p cos theta, and gradient I will write in terms of the spherical polar coordinates. So is only theta is involved, so I will write the theta term only here, and I will calculate the potential. I will calculate the field from here. So going to that one, this del, I know that the component which is involved with theta is 1 over r, and partial over partial theta in theta unit vector. So I have to write this thing. This implies that electric field is equal to minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught r square. It's independent of the integration derivation, so I will take r square outside. It will come out to be 1 over r cube, 1 over r from here, 1 over r square from here, and p as well. And then I will apply partial theta over cos theta, so it will come out to be minus sine theta in theta unit vector. So this way I will write the electric field equal to 1 minus minus become plus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and p sine of theta over r cube and theta unit vector. So the field will basically go, this is the direction of the theta unit vector, so the field will go along here. So earlier, keep in mind, earlier I have taken the arrows like this. I was looking to the P, means I was representing P here, and now when it comes out to be the electric field, then the electric field will be in this direction, in the downward direction. So not to confuse both, that I have clarified them. So we have found the electric field inside and outside of a sphere, which is the result of uniform polarization. So only the surface charge contributed to that one. The volume charge contribution was zero, and we have this thing is the field inside and outside the sphere.